Today's Advent meditation is on hope. Your opponents would love you to believe that it's hopeless, that you have no power, that there's no reason to act, that you can't win. But hope is a gift you don't have to surrender, a power you don't have to throw away. And though hope can be an act of defiance, defiance isn't enough reason to hope. And there are good reasons. It is important to say what hope is not. It is not the belief that everything was, is, or will be fine. The evidence is all around us of tremendous suffering and tremendous destruction. The hope I'm interested in is about broad perspectives with specific possibilities, ones that invite or demand that we act. It's also not a sunny, everything is getting better narrative, though it may be a counter to the everything is getting worse narrative. Patrice Cullors, one of the founders of Black Lives Matter, early on described the movement's mission as to provide hope and inspiration for collective action, to build collective power, to achieve collective transformation, rooted in grief and rage, but pointed towards vision and dreams. Change is rarely straightforward. Sometimes it's as complex as chaos theory and as slow as evolution. Even things that seem to happen suddenly arise from deep roots in the past or from long dormant seeds. If people find themselves living in a world in which some hopes are realized and some joys are incandescent, some boundaries between individuals and groups are lowered, even for an hour or a day, that matters. Memory of joy and liberation can become a navigation tool, an identity, a gift. The world often seems divided between false hope and gratuitous despair. Despair demands less of us. It's more predictable and, in a sad way, safer. Authentic hope requires clarity, seeing the troubles in this world, and imagination, seeing what might lie beyond these situations that are perhaps not inevitable, not immutable. Hopefulness is risky, since it is, after all, a form of trust. Trust in the unknown and the possible, even in discontinuity. To be hopeful is to take on a different persona, one that risks disappointment, betrayal. Political awareness without activism means looking at the devastation, your face turned toward the center of things. Activism itself can generate hope because it already constitutes an alternative and turns away from the corruption at center to face the wild possibilities and the heroes at the edge and by your side. Remember, flowers like hope are harvested and they grow in the dark.